this is SGU, and welcome back to the Russ Courtnall Be A Pro series here in NHL 17 on the Xbox One. We're jumping back into play with Russ and the Columbus Blue Jackets, trying to better that 3-4 start they've had to start the season. They take on the 5-1-2 Dallas Stars, so a little bit of a tough test for them here, but we will see what we can get done as we are here at home at Nationwide Arena, and here it goes. Cam Atkinson down the ice. He's going to try to pass to Courtnall. Doesn't get through. But Courtnall is going to forecheck effectively here, keeping the puck in the zone. And the heavy shot is going to be in the net. A goal for Columbus right there. As that's good work. Like I said, keeping the puck in the offensive zone. Courtnall may get an assist on that for his efforts. But it's going to be Jack Johnson's second goal of the season. And, Dallas comes right back before the first period ends and ties it at one. Now into the second period, just seconds in, and Dallas looking to take the lead. They pass the puck around, and oh my, that puck gets through Bobrovsky and is eventually put into the net. A bit of a soft goal. Yeah, I'm going to call it. That's a soft goal right there. Can't be having that, but Patrick Sharp is the recipient. It's 2-1. Now make it 3-1, Dallas. As we go further into this second period, down two goals now with a face-off in the offensive end. Again, Courtnall causing some disruption there, keeping the puck in the zone. Can they get a shot on net here? Well, they eventually do, and it's Cam Atkinson. He's going to score, make it a 3-2 game now with 5 minutes to play in the second period. Kerry Laitinen could not keep it out of the net. And that has awoken the fans here at Nationwide. They get something to cheer for again. And we got a brand new hockey game going into the third period. Now, just a minute or so into the game, well, it's right back to a two-goal lead as Jamie Benn finds the back of the net just a minute and 5 seconds into the period. And here we go again as they're looking to bury the Blue Jackets. And, the final seconds are ticking down. One last rush for Columbus. They are going to find the net. You kidding me? They score a goal with just about a second left, 1.8 to be exact. Not really even time to win a faceoff and get the puck on net. You can probably go ahead and file this one in the category of too little too late, but at least they get to celebrate the third goal of the night as Foligno is able to get that one to go. Nice play right there to tip it in front, actually. As you'll see the redirection and in the net. Stick below the crossbar, everything's good right there. But like I said, one face-off left and really no chance to do anything. Dallas hangs on for the 4-3 victory, comes into the building, and takes the 2 points. So another frustrating night for the Blue Jackets as they go down in defeat for the fifth time this season. Now 3-5 on the early campaign. And you see Jamie Benn's game winner right there to make it 4-3 Dallas. Next up is the Montreal Canadiens. They're 4-5. We're 3-5. Both struggling a bit here in below 500 hockey clubs. So we'll have to see what gives as the Canadiens come to Nationwide Arena. And you look at the Canadiens very much struggling here as they had just won to snap a 5-game losing streak. So the losing streak's over, but we'd like to put them right back onto another losing streak, if at all possible. So working behind the net here and hoping to gain possession of the puck. Well, that doesn't happen. Montreal gets it, and that goal beats Bobrovsky short side again. Yeah, I don't want to call it a soft goal, but you don't want to be giving up the short side right there. Andrew Shaw puts it home, and it's 1-0 Canadiens. And, let's see if we can answer back. No, Montreal makes it 2-0. As the first period ends, now we get a goal in the second period. It's 2-1. Who's going to score the next one? Montreal. We got a whole bunch of simming going on as far as when the goals are scored. But let's face off for the third period now. Down 3-1. But look at this. A turnover. And here comes Atkinson and Courtnall. And they just bum rush the net. And it ends up in the net behind Carey Price. It's now a 3-2 hockey game. And all of a sudden, these fans who may have been lulled to sleep for two periods now have reason to get excited once again. Dubinsky. I thought it was Cam Atkinson. No, it was Dubinsky with the puck down the ice. And they were just barreling home against Carey Price. It's a good thing it goes in the net, or Courtnall may get called for interference here. But it was after the fact. Goal goes to Columbus. And Dubinsky gets it. So 3-2 now, circling around. Looking to set up in front as Courtnall might have gotten just a tip on that. and a redirection, but either way, Carey Price makes the save. So another faceoff in front of Price. That shot is blocked. No problem. How about we tee it up again? Price makes the save. It goes behind the net. Courtnall's got it. Oh, he wanted to pass to the closer teammate right there. Didn't work, but they maintain possession. Working behind the net, coming out front. A shot doesn't quite get to the net. Rebound. No, another chance in front. Courtnall, can he get it on his stick? He does, but that is denied. I think it hit a defenseman. A flurry of activity, but no goal for Columbus. They find themselves trailing still 3-2, and here comes Montreal on the attack as Courtnall comes over the boards, and that puck, again, are you kidding me? That's a goal that should really not have happened. Bobrovsky has got to squeeze the pads right there, and instead it trickles through, and that may have sunk us on the night as it's now 4-2. Let's watch again as that looks pretty routine there. You got to have that save in the NHL, just saying. And Bobrovsky's better than that. Oh, never mind. Maybe it was Johnson who actually pokes that home between his goaltender's five hole. Oh, man. Well, either way, that's really depressing. So we got to try to make it up. 4 minutes left. Headman pass to Courtnall. He's got a beat, and he scores on the backhand. Going to throw that glove in the crowd and go ahead and take a couple shots from that rifle for his celebration. We are going to change that soon. I want to change it up a little bit. You may have seen a little nod to what the new one's going to be. If you saw the opening few seconds of the video and the intro, yeah, we did change it up a little bit. But for one more time, at least, for old time's sake, throwing that glove up and trying to shoot it down like he's duck hunting. So once again, we cut into a deficit late, and once again, it is too little too late. Another 4-3 final. This time, Montreal comes into the building and gets the 2 points. This is a kind of depressing theme we got going here. If you're a Columbus Blue Jackets fan, this is ending up on the wrong side of one-goal games, and we need to do something to right the ship here before things get out of hand. Russ Courtnall is your number one star. As a matter of fact, we sweep the three stars despite losing the game. It's a little unorthodox right there, but that is what happened. So the St. Louis Blues are up next. They do not have a winning record, but they will be at home at Scottrade Center as we come and invade and try to get a victory. They've been having problems. They've lost three in a row. So are we going to help out another struggling team, or are we going to get ourselves going after struggling? Let's see. Something's got to give, right? Here we go. First period. Courtnall coming up ice, gets the puck to his teammate. They're going to pass this around. Nice shot on net, and it's a goal. I think it's Dubinsky again. He's going to get the goal. Courtnall's shot initially was stopped, but that puck is a juicy rebound, and it is Brandon Dubinsky's third of the season. And we have a 1-0 Columbus lead. Oh, a couple goals traded back and forth right there. 2-1 Columbus. Big hit, and that's going to elicit a response right there. Dubinsky, who scored a goal, is maybe interested in a Gordie Howe hat trick here, as he's going to jump in and defend a teammate and get in a fight. Let's see if he can prove the point here and go ahead and win this fight. Does he have it in him? Let's see here. Dodging some punches, getting some in his own. He's going to be taken down, but no, he's back up to his feet. Not giving up that easily. Still throwing some punches, and eventually it's a takedown. So, all right. Well, stood up for a teammate there in a big way after a big hit. Legal or not, Dubinsky sends the message that we are not going to stand for that. And here we go with a faceoff. In the St. Louis end, that's a shot block right there, and another one. The defense is active. This one from the point is redirected by Courtnall, but again, a big save. Thought maybe he'd get a goal there on the redirection. It's not the case. More pushing and shoving. Let's see a replay of the effort by Courtnall to get a stick on that. Redirect the shot, but not enough to get a goal. The Blue Jackets leading 2-1. Rushing up ice again here. Courtnall calling for the pass. He's going to whiff on the shot, but not on the second one. He scores right there. And oh, new celebration time. Dance, Russ, dance. Okay, everybody stands back and lets him get his dance on. Then they swarm him. Tonight it's Columbus that'll be taking the 2-goal lead on 10th goal of the season by Russ Courtnall. Again, you see the big whiff on the shot right in the slot there. Gets Allen moving one way, and he's down and not able to recover in time for the shot that actually gets on net. So it's 3-1. Now make it 4-1 as Columbus scores the very next goal and has a 3-goal lead as we're still in the second period. Here's a chance for a hard shot from the point, and yes, sir, it's another goal. 5-1 Columbus now I believe that's Savard that's going to get the goal. And they are pouring it on the struggling St. Louis Blues here right now. Let's see if we can keep it that way, although it is 5-2 now. And Tarasenko and company are swarming around. That's going to be tipped in front. Speaking of Vladimir Tarasenko, your cover boy for NHL 17, he scores the goal. And it's 5-3, and don't look now, but St. Louis is storming back in the third period. We're going to have to stem the tie here. He gets his eighth of the season, so jumping over the boards. Courtnall looking to join the rush. He's got to kind of get back in the play here, but he's going to try to get in front of the net. It really doesn't matter because he gets out there in time to see his teammate put it in the net, and it's going to be a 6-3 lead. Three-goal lead is back in order, and that's Seth Jones, second of the year. He scores that at a very nice time there to change the momentum back in Columbus's favor. Now with just 5.5 minutes to play, this looks very similar to a play we saw earlier as he streaks up the wing, goes backhand, and he gets to dance for the second time tonight. Seventh Columbus goal, and it looks like it's going to secure a road victory. Courtnall's second of the night, 11th of the season, and he's electrified by his new dance moves, his celly. After scoring again here, you see the desperation effort by Allen coming across the crease and the dive, but it is not going to bring this one back. Russ Courtnall scores, and okay. ISO on the dance. Got to see it up close and personal. Yeah, I don't know if I'm sold on it, but it's fun. It's fun for now. We'll keep it for the time being. This game is over. 7-3 is your final. Columbus on this night finally gets to celebrate a victory. That one feels good. What is that, their fourth of the season? It's kind of interesting because when you go to start up a game, they show the stats on your starting goaltender, and it's wrong for Bobrovsky every time. It shows him as like 0-3, although clearly he's gotten some wins on the season. Anyway, 7-3 Columbus, and they win this one going away in St. Louis. We once again sweep the three stars with Russ Courtnall being your first star of the game. So we're going to continue on in the rookie season. When we come back, we got Anaheim up next, unless we choose to sim forward a little bit. Russ Courtnall coming right back at you, dance moves and all. We will see you next time.